into the first section of the analysis, verbal ability, the pattern was very similar to CAT. There were 5 RCs with 24 questions. You had para-jumbles, 4 questions, para-summary 3, odd one out 3. Now this, you might, in CAT, you might have one less para-summary and a para-completion. So that is a little bit of deviation which is possible. Depends year to year. Now, see, verbal section in CAT has clearly two parts, VRC and VR. VRC is the reading comprehension part. Typically, I suggest, given the level in the last 4 years, you should be thinking of reading all the questions and all the passages, but attempting those which you think you are sure. You should be very careful about avoiding guesses in the verbal section, especially at this point of time when CAT is 5 months still away. So particularly coming to this paper, I personally felt that the first RC was a bit lengthy, but as it happens with most lengthy comprehensions, generally the questions are query based and easy to solve. The RC on Gfactory, that RC was easy to read, but I felt that the questions were a bit tricky. Overall, the reading comprehension level was, I would say, easy to moderate, and that is the kind of level which usually comes in CAT these days. Alright, for the past 3 years, verbal has not been a difficult section. However, in some mocks, we will be making the level of verbal difficult as well. Verbal reasoning, I felt, was a bit on the moderate to difficult side, because the questions were lengthy, the sentences were lengthy in size, and there were certain questions wherein you could get confused amongst two possible combinations, especially in para-jumbles and a bit in odd one out. So overall, coming to the section, I feel RC was a touch easy, VR was at a good level, which was moderately difficult. If you see the number of questions you get in your analysis, question wise, the time estimated and the level of difficulty. So if you sum that up, there were 17 easy questions and 17 moderate questions. So in totality, if you could select the ones, so you need to have speed, right? You need to read very fast, read the RCs fast, read the passage fast, and try to mark only those questions where you are sure. So those are the easy ones. So 50% of the section was easy. Getting a score 50 or above was easily possible. For high percentile aspirants, you could have scored pretty well in this paper. I mean, in the range of 70 or more as well. So that is my overall analysis on the verbal section. Thank you. Coming to the DIRR section, I found this section to be moderately difficult. It wasn't easy. I will not also call it the most difficult possible DIRR. Now, for the past 3 to 4 years, if you see, DIRR in CAT has consistently been on the moderate to difficult side. Now, the variation has been, you will always get 3 to 4 difficult sets, right? But there are a couple, it depends. If you get 2 to 3 easy ones, then you are very lucky. But normally the case is you will hardly get one easy set, but there will be 2 to 3 sets which will be at a moderate level of difficulty. So it is very important that in DIRR you focus on the right kinds of topics. This particular section I like because there were a couple of sets on ordering sequencing. Now ordering sequencing and group formation, which means LR based questions, that has become a very important part in CAT DIRR these days. Even questions where you need to read the case and form tables, or questions where you have to order or group inside tables where values are given, numerical based DIRR. So this particular section had such ordering sequencing etc. based questions, so that was good. Overall, apart from the third set which was tabular, which I would say was at an easier level, the other questions were reasonably moderate in the difficulty level, right? You had to spend some time in understanding the set and then solving them down. Some students have done really well and that is good, right? But so for this particular section, you need to build lots of practice of structuring information. So I suggest practice lots of unstructured DILR in your preparation. Focus less on graphs and tables. Despite this particular paper also had a graph, right? But most other sets were caselet based. Like set number 2, 6 and 7, they were mostly LR and DI type caselets, alright? Next, I also like the maxima minima set theory based question in this paper. Now these are concepts, maxima minima, set overlap, data aggregation, entry matching. These kinds of concepts come a lot in CAT these days, right? So I would say moderate paper similar to CAT, maybe a little bit lower than most difficult CAT, but very relevant for CAT. Alright, and in the coming mocks, we'll try to mix and match the important types and give you the most appropriate practice for CAT DILR. Thank you. Hello students, the quant section now. Overall, I put this section at a moderate level. It wasn't easy. It was not very difficult. Very relevant, given the kind of level that has come in CAT. If you see, CAT 2016 was slightly moderate to difficult. CAT 17 was easy in quants. And CAT 18 was again on the slightly moderate to difficult side. So, this paper, this particular section, I would put it at a very good level given the CAT pattern. Overall, the analysis, if you have seen the question labels, there were 12 questions which were easy. There were 20 which were moderate and 2 that were difficult. Now, on this, generally in CAT, what you will see, there are usually more than 2 difficult questions, maybe 4 to 5 difficult questions. But then, the moderate ones were more in this paper. So, overall, you will get a feeling that this was slightly trickier paper, not that easy to solve. The 2 difficult questions particularly which I have marked in this paper, the first one was the third question on time and work, and the next one was on sequence series, particularly down at number 30, right? So, the difficult, easy or moderate questions can come from any topic. The point is, you need to have that habit of picking up the easy ones and solve. So, overall, the first, these easy 12 questions should have been your catch, right? The next level of analysis, I've just gone through this in terms of time spent or the ideal time for a particular question. Number of questions which are given as 2-minute solvable, they are 13 and easy were 12. So, mostly these were the questions you needed to pick, right? Number of questions with 3 minutes expected time were 16. So, in the moderate part also, there were many questions which could have been solved in appropriate time. So, if you have a topic which you are very comfortable with and it's given as moderate, but still you can solve it in maybe 2 to 3 minutes because you are good in that topic. So that is how you deal with the moderate questions. There were 5 questions which were 4 minutes, you know. And now these are the type of questions which generally you want to avoid in CAT. Alright, because giving 4 to 5 minutes on a particular question in the quant section is not advisable. So that is something which you should keep in mind right from now. Selection is very important in quants. As soon as you read a question, before you start solving, you should be very clear whether you are going to crack it this time or not. If you are not sure, bookmark it. If you don't understand it totally, simply leave it. This selection automatically ensures speed and accuracy and makes you traverse through the section till the last question. Right? So this is something which you need to keep in mind in the quant section. In the coming mocks, especially the mock 16, which is a mock where I will be giving my video analysis, be sure that you will be getting a higher level across sections because I want you all to face the difficulty thing right at the beginning, at the time when you have just started with your mocks. Alright, thank you. Hello students, this video is about overall understanding of Bfactory mocks. This particular mock was at a moderate level of difficulty. In terms of level overall, if we compare the sections, I personally felt that verbal was slightly on the easier side. But quants and DI were pretty much at moderate to difficult level according to the pattern which has come overall in CAT 16, 17, 18, right? The levels will vary, the levels will fluctuate. One thing for sure that the topics from which the questions come and the type of topics which need more weightage, we will be keeping that balance appropriate. For example, in the DILR section, there were 3 caselets, 2 sets of ordering sequencing. Now, that is the kind of pattern which you expect in CAT. In quantitative, there were approximately 15, 16 questions from arithmetic. So again, a topic which comes a lot in CAT, right? So the kind of balance which you need for CAT, that will be maintained, all right? We have a very good team of efficient faculty members, including us directors, who keep a track on what level and the types which we are putting into mocks. It's a very dynamic and current CAT pattern-based mock test series, all right? Coming to the second part of this video, how should you analyze the analytics part? In Bfactory, what we believe that is more important than the overall the hi-fi analytics of how many easy, difficult, etc. What matters more is you, when you do your resolving of the paper with the solution, every question you should understand ki how much time should ideally have been spent and what was the level of difficulty and from what topic are you able to solve questions easily and where are you finding that difficulty. So what we do is, before the solution that you get in any particular question, right? In the beginning you get the level of difficulty, the topic and also the expected time to solve, right? The idea is, because as a student, I always tell my students, I have been a student who had a passion for teaching, so I can understand how you practice, right? Once you are done with the mock, you try to resolve it, go through the solution. When you read the question, you should understand that ye banna chahiye tha, you should have solved it or you should have left it, right? So that analysis is per question based to make you understand that whether you should solve, attempt, leave, or how much time should you spend. So introspect looking at that analysis question by question. Coming at the next level of analytics, you also get information on, according to section, that what was the percentage accuracy and what was your score, percentile, right? Now, coming to the score part, at this level, not each one of you might already be well totally prepared for CAT. And I'm 100% sure each one of you has a scope to improve far more, given that CAT is 5 months away. So the most important parameter should be accuracy. Make sure that in any section, your accuracy should be at a very high level. Because see what happens. If I am 90%, 95% accurate from now, maybe right now in quants I am attempting 15 questions, that will increase with my practice, with my mocks, right? We have 100 mocks to come. So that will increase. When I attempt 20, that accuracy should still be 95%. When I attempt 25, the accuracy should remain. It should not happen that you are very less accurate. So the one important parameter at this point of time which I wanted to point out is, in terms of overall analysis, make sure that your accuracy is good. Now, how to make sure? Try to restrict your guesses. Try to talk to yourself when you're doing the analysis that, oh shit, I made a particular kind of error, I should not repeat it. Be conscious of mistake patterns. If you keep this in mind, you will keep improving test by test. Alright? So just doing the resolution of the mock is not enough. You also should introspect and decide what were the mistakes. Possibly write them down. We call it making mistake patterns. So that you don't repeat such mistakes in the upcoming mocks. Before doing this kind of an analysis, do not take the next mock. So understand, if you give a 3-hour mock, it's very important to spend another maybe 5 to 7 hours on doing a complete resolving and analysis of the mock. Then you should take the next mock. Alright, coming to the last part, how percentile, what percentile means at Bfactory. The percentile which is calculated is your relative performance, but it is not just given by the number of students which take mock this year. We are expecting, the numbers might increase, but we are expecting 1500 to 2000 students to be taking Bfactory CAT 19, right? But most of the mocks, apart from some question changes, the question has a base, and we have a data of last 4 years, 6 to 7,000 students who have taken most of these mocks. So a bit of question change deviation is considered, and the data is fair. So practically, it's a complex algorithm which has been developed as a percentile calculator. Practically, the percentile that you get is a comparison out of 6 to 7,000 students in every mock. So the result is pretty accurate, even in terms of your relative performance. All you need to ensure is, once you take a mock, stop worrying about any other factors. Just try that when you're doing the analysis, you do it properly. And before attempting the next mock, which you should again do very seriously, make sure that you work on your mistakes. Alright? So that is the way you actually improve from one mock to mock. Alright? So that is it. Signing off, Rahul Anand, Director of Bfactory. Thank you.